of mathematics class 10. Dear students, in the previous video we learned different formulae for the surface area and volume of the solids like cube, cuboid, cone, cylinder, hemisphere and sphere. Okay, so in this video by using this formulae we are going to solve some examples. Okay, so let's see. Here we have the first question. The dimensions of cuboid are 44 cm, 21 cm and 12 cm. It is measured and a cone of height 24 cm is made. Find the radius of its base. Okay? So dear students, in this question, a cuboid with its dimension are given. So that cuboid is melted and from that a cone is formed. The height of cone is given 24 cm. So for that cone, we ask to find out its base radius. Okay? So let's see how to solve this question. So here, first of all, we'll write down the dimension of this cuboid. So its length is given, that is L, 44 cm. Breadth is given B, 21 cm. Height is given 12 cm. So here, there are two heights. One is the height of cuboid and one is the height of cone. Okay, so let's consider the height of this cuboid as h1. Okay, similarly for cone, height of cone, that is h2, is equal to 24 cm. Okay, so these things are given to us. So dear students, it's good to write the given. So from that we come to know that whether the given values have same units or not. Okay, so one care we have to take that before going to solve these questions, make sure that the given values have the same units. If they are not in the same units, then we have to convert them in the same units before putting the values in the formula. Okay, so already these are in the same units. Okay, so we have to find out the radius of cone. So consider the radius of the cone as r. Okay, so let the radius of cone be r. Now here the cuboid is melted into the cone. Right? So here, whatever is the volume of cuboid, same will be the cone. Okay? So here we will see that volume of cuboid is equal to volume of cone. Okay? So write down the formula for volume of cuboid. Volume of cuboid is equal to L into B into H. And volume of cone is equal to 1 upon 3 pi r square H. So as we had considered the height of cuboid as h1, so write down here h1 and for cone as h2. Okay, so this h1 and h2 shows that the values are different. Okay, now let's put the value L 44, breadth 21, h1 is given 12. Okay, similarly here 1 upon 3, value of part 22 upon 7, r we have to find out, so r square will be as it is, and height of cone is given 24. Okay, so that we have written here. Okay, now here we can see here this 3 will be 3 8 is 24. So in this way we can reduce where it is possible. Then keeping the r square there itself, remaining values will transfer to the LHS. Okay, so here 24 multiplied by 21 multiplied by 12. This 7 is dividing, it will multiply. Okay, and 22 into this 8. These are in the multiplying, these are multiplying here, so it will divide. Okay, now let's solve this. So here 22 ones are 22, 22 twos are 44, then 2 ones are 2, 2 fours, then 4 ones are 4, 4 threes. Okay, so here this 21 and 3 sevens are 21. Okay, so here as r square is there, so r square is equal to 21 into 21. Therefore, r is equal to 21. Okay, taking out the square root from both sides. Okay, so in this way we got the value of r. And what is the r? Radius of the cone. Okay, so radius of the base of the cone is 21 centimeter. Okay, so I hope it's clear to you. Let's see another example. A cylinder and a cone have equal bases. The height of the cylinder is 3 cm
and the area of its base is 100 square centimeter. The cone is placed upon the cylinder. Volume of the solid figure so formed is 500 cubic centimeter. Find the total height of the figure.
Dear students, in this question, we have a cylinder with a height 3 cm. Okay? Height of the cylinder is 3 cm. Okay? Then its base area is given, that is 100 square cm. On this cylinder, a cone is placed. This base of the cone and base of the cylinder both are equal. Okay? As the bases are equal, it means the cone and cylinder have same radii. Okay? So here we asked to find out the total height of this solid which is formed by the combination of this cylinder and a cone. Okay? Now here, total height we want to find out. Already the height of cylinder is given, only we have to find out the height of cone. Okay? Again, one more thing is given, that volume of this solid which is formed by this cone and cylinder, that volume is given 500 cubic centimeter. Okay, and we have to find out its total height. So let's see how to find out. So here a cylinder and a cone have equal bases, therefore their radii are equal. Okay, let the radii be radius be r. Then here area of base is given 100 square centimeter. And here, area of base, that is circular only, that is nothing but the area of circle, okay, which is the value of pi r square. So here, this 100 square centimeter is the value of pi r square. Radius is not given, instead of that, we are given the base area. And base area is nothing but pi r square, okay. Now here, height, we have to find out the height of cone. Okay, so let's consider the height of this cylinder as h1 and height of cone as h2. Let h1 and h2 be the heights of cylinder and cone respectively. Therefore here h1 is already given, that is 3 cm. Okay, now here volume of this solid figure is given 500 cubic centimeter. Now volume of this solid figure is nothing but volume of cylinder plus volume of cone. Okay, now here the value of this volume of solid is given 500. The volume of cylinder, the formula is pi r square h. As we have considered the height of this cylinder as h1, so we will say here pi r square h1 plus volume of cone 1 upon 3 pi r square h. Okay, but here we had considered its height as h2, so we will say here 1 upon 3 pi r square h2. Now dear students, here as we know that their radii are equal, it means that its values are same. So let's take it out as a common. So in the bracket h1 plus 1 upon 3 h2. Okay, and here value is, volume of this solid is 500. Okay. Now, this value of this pi r square, that is already given 100. So, let's put that. H1 is given 3 cm plus 1 upon 3 h2. Okay. Now, this 100 is multiplied to this bracket, it will divide. Okay. And this 0 will be cancelled. Now, here, in a bracket 3 plus 1 upon 3 h2. So, here, we have to add this. But here we have to take the LCM, that is 3 is the 9 plus h2 upon 3. Okay. Now here we got the pi upon 1, that is nothing but pi only. Okay. And this 3 is dividing, it will multiply to this 5. Okay. As we will transfer it to the LHS, is equal to 9 plus h2. Now 5 is the 15, is equal to 9 plus h2. As we want to find out the value of h2. So let's transfer this 9. As it is a plus, it will be minus. Okay, so 15 minus 9, that is 6. So in this way, we got the value of h2. h2 is nothing but the height of cone. Our question is, find out the total height of this solid. Okay, so this we got 3 cm, already it is given. And now the height of cone we got, that is 6. Okay, so let's find out total height of the So 3 plus 6, that is 9 cm. So in this way, height of the figure is 9 cm. Okay, I hope this question is clear to you.
Now let's see another example. In figure, a toy made from hemisphere, a cylinder and a cone is shown. Find the total area of the toy.
Dear students, in this question, there is a toy which is a combination of hemisphere, cylinder and a cone. And we asked to find out the total surface area of this toy. Okay, now we have to find out its total surface area. We have to find out curved surface area of hemisphere, then curved surface area of this cylinder and curved surface area of this cone. Okay, now here this toy is a combination of cone, cylinder and hemisphere. That's why their bases are equal. As the bases are equal means they have the same radius. Okay, so their radius is same, so we can consider it as a R. Okay, so a toy is made up of hemisphere, cylinder and a cone. They have equal bases, therefore their radius are radii are equal. So let's consider their radius as R, which is given 3 cm. Okay. Now, let the height of the conical part and the cylinder as H1 and H2 respectively. Okay, therefore H1, which is the height of cone, that is 4 cm, and H2, that is the height of cylinder, which is given 40 cm. Okay, now here to find out the curved surface area of cone, we have the formula pi r l. Okay, but in this question, here we have the height, that is h, 4 cm and radius 3 cm. Slant height L is not given. Okay, so first of all we have to find out the value of L, and we know that here we will apply the Pythagoras theorem. We have studied that in the previous video. Okay, that is L square is equal to h square plus r square. So here h is height of the cone, which we have considered as the h1. Okay, so h1 square plus r square. So here h1, that is height of the cone, is given 4. So 4 square plus radius is 3, that is 3 square. Okay, square of 4 is 16, square of 3 is 9, 16 plus 9 is equal to 25, 25 is the square of 5. It means that L is equal to 5. By taking out the square root, we got the value of L as 5. Okay, now here let's find out the total area of a toy. Total area of this toy is equal to curved surface area of hemisphere, right? Curved surface area of hemisphere plus curved surface area of this cylinder plus curved surface area of this cone. Okay, so that only curved surface area of hemisphere, curved surface area of cylinder plus curved surface area of cone. So let's write down the formula for each solution. Curved surface area of hemisphere 2 pi r square plus curved surface area of cylinder, that is 2 pi r h. But we have considered the height of cylinder as h2, so we will say here 2 pi r h2 plus curved surface area of cone pi r l. Okay, now here you can see here pi, which is common for all these three terms. Similarly, radius, which is equal, so that also we can take out as a common. So what will remain in the bracket? 2 and 1 of the r plus 2, this pi r is outside, so remain h2. So 2 h2 plus pi r is outside, remain only l. Okay, now let's put the value of this height and slant height. So here pi into radius is 3 into bracket 2 radius 3 plus 2 into h2, value of h2 is 14 plus slant height L, we got it as a 5. Okay, so here value of pi we can put, that is 3.14 into 3 into bracket 2 3 is 6, 42 is 18 plus 5. Okay, after adding this, we will get it as a 91. Okay, and this 3.14 into 3, the product of this will get 9.42 into 91. Okay, so here after multiplying, we will get the product 857.22 square centimeter. So, dear student, here we ask to find out the area, that's why the unit will be square centimeter or centimeter square. Okay, so in this way, we have found out the total area of the toy, that is 857.22 square centimeter. Okay, so I hope it's clear to you. Okay, let's see one more example.
Now we have the question. In figure, a cylindrical wrapper of flat tablets is shown. The radius of tablet is 7 mm and its thickness is 5 mm. How many such tablets are wrapped in the wrapper?
Dear students, in this question, we have a cylindrical wrapper. Okay, so you might have seen that Prince pocket and that like this polo. Okay, so this is a cylindrical wrapper and here there are tablets. Okay, that tablets are also cylindrical. Now for this wrapper, we are given with its height, that is 10 cm and its diameter is also given 14 mm. Okay, and for the tablets which are inside, so it's a radius is also given and its height is also given. Then we ask to find out the number of tablets that can be wrapped in this cylindrical wrapper, that we have to find out. Okay, so let's see how to solve this question. Now here, four tablets, let's write down its radius, that is R. So consider its radius as R1, which is given 7 mm. Then its thickness, thickness means height only. Okay, so that is H1, which is 5 mm. Then for cylindrical wrapper, for this cylindrical wrapper, its diameter is given. So dear students, you have to be very careful. The given value is of diameter or radius. Okay, so here we are given the diameter. It is not mentioned the word diameter, but from the figure you can understand that this pole is given 14. That is nothing but the diameter. So diameter is given 14 mm and this length is given 10 cm. So that length is nothing but the height. So for this wrapper, let's consider its radius as R2 and height as H2. Okay. Now here, while solving the questions on this solution, we have to check that whether the values are in the same units or not. Now here, these are in the millimeter. Okay. But this height of this wrapper, cylindrical wrapper, is given in the centimeter. So we have to convert it into the millimeter. So we are knowing the relation that 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeter. That's why 10 into 10, that is 100 millimeter. So in this way, we'll get the height of the cylindrical wrapper in the millimeter. Okay. Now here, number of tablets which can be wrapped in this wrapper. This is the question related with the volume. Okay, so that's why number of tablets that can be wrapped in this wrapper is equal to volume of this wrapper upon volume of a tablet. Okay, so as both are the cylindrical only, so we will write the formula of cylinder. Volume of cylinder, that is pi r square h. So for wrapper, pi r2 square h2. As we had considered, its radius and height as r2 h2. And for tablet, it's pi r1 square h. Sorry, here h1. Okay. So let's put the value. So here this pi will get cancelled. Radius of the wrapper is 7. So 7 into 7. Its height is 100. Okay. And for this tablet, its radius is 7 into 7. And its height is given 5. Okay, so let's solve this. This 7 will get cancelled. That is 100 upon 5. So we will get its answer as 20. Okay, therefore 20 tablets can be wrapped in the wrapper. Okay, so in this way, we had find out the number of tablets that can be wrapped in the cylindrical wrapper, that is 20. So dear students, here as we asked to find out the number of tablets, so surely here we should get the answer as a natural number. It should not be in the fraction or decimal point. Okay, so I hope this question is clear. Okay, let's see one more example.
Now we have the question. As shown in the figure, a cylindrical glass contains water. A metal sphere of diameter 2 cm is immersed in it. Find the volume of the water.
In this question, we have a cylindrical glass container immersed with a sphere. Okay? Then height of the water is given when the sphere is immersed. That height is given 30 cm. Okay? Then diameter of the cylindrical container is also given, and for sphere its diameter is given. Then here we ask to find out the volume of water only, means without this sphere. Okay, so how we solve this question? So to get the answer for this question, first of all we have to find out the volume of this water with the sphere. Okay, from that volume we'll remove the volume of sphere. Okay, then we get the volume of water only, that is without sphere. Okay, so let's write down here. Height of the water in cylindrical container. Okay, with the sphere, that is given 30 cm. Okay, then here diameter of container is given. This diameter is given 14 cm. So we need radius. So radius is of the diameter, that is 7 cm. Okay, so let's consider its radius as R. Okay, now diameter of sphere is given. Again, here for sphere radius is not given, diameter is given. So again, be careful. So diameter of sphere is given 2 cm. Therefore, its radius is 1 cm. So let's consider its radius as R. Okay, now let's find out the volume of water in the glass with the sphere. Okay, with the sphere, what is the volume of this glass or water? Okay, so here pi r1 square 8. So we are writing that volume of cylinder is equal to pi r square 8. As we have considered its radius as r1, so pi r1 square 8. Okay, so let's put the value. So here we are going to find out the value in terms of pi. Okay, so no need to put the value of pi. Okay, so here pi into radius is 7 into height is given 30 cm. Okay, so after multiplying, we'll get the product 1470 pi cubic centimeter as is the volume. Okay, similarly we'll find out the volume of sphere. We are writing the formula, volume of sphere is equal to 4 upon 3 pi r cube. So as its radius we had considered r2, so we'll say r2 cube. Okay, then put the value 4 upon 3, value of pi, here we not have to put, so pi as it is into r2, value of r2 is 1 into 1 into 1, as cube is there. Okay, so we'll get the volume of sphere 4 upon 3 pi. Okay, so let's reduce this. So here convert it in a decimal fraction, so we'll get 1.33. okay, that is correct. So here 1.33 pi cubic centimeter is the volume of sphere. We ask to find out the volume of water only. Okay, means without sphere. So how we find out that? So volume of water without sphere, so from this volume remove the volume of sphere, we will get the volume of water only. So here volume of water without sphere is equal to volume of water with the sphere, okay, minus volume of sphere. So let me find out that 1470 pi minus 1.33 pi. Okay, so after subtracting we get the 1468.67 pi cubic centimeter. So this is the volume of water. Okay, so if you want to put the value of pi, you can put it as a 3.14 So we will get the volume of water. So volume of water is 1468.67 per cubic centimeter. Okay. So dear students, in this video we had solved the some examples. Okay. In which we had the surface area, per surface area, or total surface area, or volume of the different solids like cuboid, cylinder, cone, sphere, etc. I hope all the questions are clear to you. Thank you.